Michael, how are you?
I found something really interesting.
The whole housing market is propped up on these bad loans. They will fail.
The housing market is rock solid.
It's a time bomb. So Mike Burry, who gets his hair cut at Supercuts and doesn't wear shoes, knows more than Alan Greenspan.
Dr. Mike Burry, yes, he does.
You know what? I'm pissed off. American people are getting screwed by the big banks. And I am getting madder and madder.
It's unbelievable.
Then this guy walks into my office and says,
there's some shady stuff going down.
All the banks were having a big old party. A few outsiders saw what no one else could.
The whole world economy might collapse.
I'm sure the world's banks have more incentives than greed.
You're wrong.
No one's paying attention.
The banks got greedy. We can profit off of their stupidity. You want to bet against the banks?
I think we're either high or having a stroke. Kind of brilliant.
Fraud has never, ever worked. Eventually, things go south. When the hell did we forget all that?
How can the banks let this happen?
It's fueled by stupidity.
But that's not stupidity, that's fraud.
Tell me the difference between stupid and illegal, and I'll have my wife's brother arrested.
You have any idea what you just did? You just bet against the American economy.
If you're wrong, you can lose it all. The banks and defraud of the American people. Now we can kick them in the teeth.
Okay, here we go.
Share prices continued to tumble.
Lehman Brothers was forced to declare itself bankrupt.
The largest single point drop.
The regulators, they had the power to do every case that I made when I was state attorney general. They just didn't want it.
We are watching this tsunami coming.
They were having massive private gains at public loss.
A financial engineer built dreams. When those dreams turn out to be nightmares, other people pay for it.
Bear Stearns, Goldman Sachs, Lehman Brothers, they knew what was happening.
What do you think about selling securities which your own people think are crap? Does that bother you
as a hypothetical?
No, this is real.
What do you think of Wall Street incomes these days?
Excessive. By 1986, he was making millions of dollars and thought it was because he was smart.
Chuck Prince famously said, we have to dance until the music stops. Actually, the music had stopped already when he said that.
At some point, I used the word Armageddon.
These people are risk takers. They're impulsive. I see a lot of cocaine use, prostitution.
So do these guys know that they were doing something dangerous?
I think they did.
I don't hear confessions.
What can we believe in? There's nothing we can trust anymore.
We had a whole group of people looking at this for whatever reason.
You can't be serious. If you would have looked, you would have found things.
It's a Wall Street government.
Why do you think there isn't a more systematic investigation being undertaken?
Because then you'll find the culprits.
I don't believe I have to discuss that with you.
Mr. Dale, these are extraordinary times, as you very well must know.
I don't understand.
The majority of this floor is being let go today.
Eric, I'm very sorry.
I was working on something, but they wouldn't let me finish it. So, take a look at it. Be careful.
Right to me.
There are $8 trillion of paper around the world relying on that equation.
But we were wrong.
No, you mean you were wrong.
Sir, if those assets decrease by just 25%,
that loss would be greater than the current market capitalization of this entire company.
How long would it take to clear that from our books?
You cannot be doing what you're thinking of doing.
Sell it all today.
You're selling something that you know has no value.
So that we may survive. There are three ways to make a living in this business. Be first, be smarter, or cheat.
Look at these people wandering around with absolutely no idea what's about to happen.
You're a very important piece of this puzzle. Are you in on this?
I can tell you that people are going to say some very nasty things about what we do here today.
If we're going down, and you damn well know it'll be together.
I'm not sure that I do know that.
The ground is shifting below our feet.
Remember this day, boys. Remember this day.
The rich are getting richer, everyone else is struggling. Is that fair? Bankers made hundreds of billions in the run-up to the crash, then all of us gave them hundreds of billions to pay off their debts. So we were in debt.
Cheers. Because we are all in this together.
There will be cutbacks, closures, jobs will be lost.
Did the bankers pay back their huge bonuses? No. They carried on making more money. This is what we've come to expect as normal. It doesn't have to be like this.
You've got to have some bankers going to prison for criminal behaviour.
I'm looking for Fred Goodwin.
We're from Reception, please.
Did you know about the 500 million in bonuses last year? Did you get some of that?
No, I'm not.
I'm starting to think that you're involved in some high-level financial skullduggery. I'm a part of day. A cleaner working in the city would have to work 300 years to make the same amount their boss would make in a year. People in the same office, but living in different worlds.
Some people have so much, some people have nothing.
This is the institutionalization of greed. It's Russell Brand to speak to Lord Rothermere. Say it's about living here and taxes. Hello? Every crisis is an opportunity to change the system, to change direction. Power isn't there. Power is here.
The Bennion estates did pull out of the purchase of the estate. So that was amazing.
Our challenge as people is to say, we will not let this happen anymore. We will bring back power into our own hands.
Things can change. Things do change.